Hello everybody and welcome to this program that is called Vamos para la Universidad. Remember, this is the English course level 1 and today we are going to have our session number 20, right? Our 20th session. I want to say hello to the different institutions that are connected with us. We have Institución Educativa Gaspar de Rodas. Hello. We have Institución Educativa that is from San José de Betulia. Okay, welcome to the session. We have Liceo El Bagre. We have Institución Educativa de Elmira Álvarez. We have Institución Educativa Lorenzo Yalim. And we have Institución Educativa Luis Andrade. Okay, so welcome to this session. I'm very happy to be with you. I really like sharing with you these sessions in which we are going to learn English to practice English. Okay? Saludo muy especial. También quiero aprovechar para mandar un saludo muy especial a aquellas instituciones que nos ven en diferido por medio de los videos de YouTube. So we have, for example, Institución Educativa Atanasio Girardot in Girardota. We have Institución Educativa Guillermo Aguilar in Yolombó. We have Institución Educativa Santa Rosa de Lima in Giraldo. We have Institución Educativa La Esmeralda in El Bagre. We have also Institución Educativa Colombia in Carepa. We have Institución Educativa Gabriela Mistral in Copacabana. Institución Educativa Cecilia Duque de Duque in Abejorral. We have also Institución Educativa Mariano de Jesús EUCC Rural Chocholoma in Angostura. And finally, we have Institución Educativa La Trinidad in Arboletes. Okay? So remember that we are in the unit number 3. We are the unit number 3. Okay? Remember that the name of the unit is... Okay, I want to say something. Institución Educativa de Elmira Álvarez is from Fredonia. Thank you very much for giving me that information. So, in Fredonia. Remember that the title of this unit is Let's Have a Party, right? Estamos en el marco, ¿cierto? De este título que es Let's Have a Party, okay? And we are talking about parties, but what specifically? Do you remember something? We are talking about a party, yes, but who is the person that is offering the party? We are talking also about a birthday, right? So who is the person that is going to have that birthday party? ¿De quién estamos hablando? ¿De la fiesta de quién? ¿Del cumpleaños de quién? Do you remember? Okay, I want to say welcome to Institución Educativa Rural Nuevo Horizonte. I think they are in El Carmen de Viboral. I'm not sure. If I'm wrong, please tell me. So, please tell me, do you remember the party, the birthday? ¿La fiesta de quién? ¿De quién estamos hablando nosotros acá en esta unidad? Okay, hello, Institución Educativa Nuevo Horizonte. Okay, I'm going to give you the clue. Remember, we are talking about Fernanda's party. Yes, very good. Thank you, Institución Educativa Gaspar de Rodas. We are talking about Fernanda's party. So, we are going to start our session. Remember that the goals of this week are... comprender ideas, recuerden que estamos hablando de los goals, los objetivos. Comprender ideas generales y específicas sobre cómo preparar comidas, particularmente para ocasiones especiales. Dar instrucciones de cómo preparar una receta y comparar precios de los ingredientes para una receta. Ok, so I want to start this session. By asking you about the name of these vegetables. So, recuerden que en la sesión anterior habíamos recomendado entrar a la plataforma en el espacio de la mochila, ¿cierto? Para poder aprender vocabulario sobre cómo llamar los productos de relacionados con la comida en inglés. Entonces vamos a ver de qué tanto nos acordamos. So, could you please tell me the name of these products, of these ingredients? Vamos a ver si me comparten en el chat nombres de los productos de la comida que estamos viendo en pantalla. Okay, we have onion, very good, tomato or tomatoes, very good, potatoes, cucumber, right? Okay, we have lettuce. Yes. What else? Yes, that's right. Carrot. Where is the carrot? Maybe this one? I don't know. Let's say carrot. Okay, let's say broccoli. Okay, what else? What other things? Okay, we have the potatoes. Okay, so remember the invitation is to go to the mochila, right? And now remember that you say potato, right? Okay, cabbage is okay. So, cabbage, I don't know, maybe... Where is cabbage? Maybe over here. So we can say like cabbage. Okay, remember. Recuerden que en la sección de la mochila... Muy bien, tenemos por acá otros... Digamos que por este lado tenemos el garlic. Recuerden que en la sección de la mochila vamos a encontrar un archivo en PDF que es muy importante que lo revisemos porque ahí tenemos mucho vocabulario que nos va a servir para poder hablar de los ingredientes. ¿Cierto? Vamos a hablar, por ejemplo, también de los lemons. Right. Very good. Avocado. Right. Yes. Very good. Coconut, right? Coconuts, apples. Yeah, very good. So I'm going to show you the presentation, the PDF file. Miren, entonces les hago toda la invitación para que vayamos al espacio de la mochila, que vamos a encontrar este archivo. Me parece que es muy útil. Tenemos aquí organizada ingredientes, ¿cierto? Por ejemplo, empezamos con carne: meat, beef, ground beef, pork, ham, bacon. So we are going to go to the chicken, egg, and then we have, for example, vegetables. You see here we have the name of the vegetable: broccoli, cabbage, carrots, cauliflower, cucumber, garlic, green peppers, green onions. Then we have fruits: apple, banana, orange, guava, pineapple, watermelon. So it's very important to study, to review this file. Recuerden que es muy importante. Muchas veces nosotros queremos decir algo, pero nos falta el vocabulario. Bueno, esta es una forma de empezar a practicarlo, ¿cierto? La invitación es para que vayamos al espacio de la mochila y empecemos a practicar ese vocabulario. Y why not using it? ¿Y por qué no utilizarlo también? Cada que vayamos a almorzar, a comer alguna cosa, pensemos qué ingredientes tiene ese alimento y empezamos a recordarlos en inglés. Okay, so here we have vegetables. Okay, so we write vegetables. vegetables. Okay. So I'm going to continue. This is just to like activate your vocabulary. Remember the pronunciation. Vegetables. Okay. So I have these questions. The idea is to discuss. Where do people usually buy groceries in your town? Is there a market in your municipality? When do you go to the market? And do you go to the market too? So here we have four questions. Tenemos cuatro preguntas. Where do people usually buy groceries in your town? Is there a market in your municipality? When do people go to the market? And do you go to the market too? Vamos a ver, me dicen si están claras las preguntas o si de pronto no están muy claras. So we can explain it. Vamos a tratar de responderlas en oraciones completas, ¿cierto? Okay, for example, in Lorenzo Yalí, they say, where do people usually buy groceries in your town? Where, in the Susana's store, I think. Please help me with that. Okay. I want to say thank you to Institución Educativa Presbítero Jesús Antonio Gómez or Gutiérrez. Please tell me the complete name in the chat. Okay, I'm going to say in my example, okay? For example, in Medellin, let's say we buy groceries at La Minorista. You see? And we can say also, for example, at the Éxito, Euro, so in Medellín, right? For example, Gaspar de Rodas says, in our town, there are three markets. Okay, three supermarkets. Right? So, Gaspar de Rodas, could you please remind us the name of your town? Okay, for example, Lorenzo Yalí, they say Marce Store. Right? So, then is the name of the store. Very good. Okay, for example, in Yalí, we buy groceries at El Emiranto. So that's the name of the market, of the supermarket. Tenemos el nombre entonces del lugar donde compran en Yalí. Thank you very much. Gaspar de Rodas says, in Jardín. So they buy the groceries, something in Caucasia. That's the name of the store. Okay. Oh, Cosechero. Okay, very good. For example, what else? Okay, let's continue with, for example, okay, Nuevo Horizonte says, in our town, we buy groceries in Idema's Market, Simona's Supermarket, and in the neighborhood store. Hey, very good, very complete sentence. Thank you very much, Institución Educativa Nuevo Horizonte. The Liceo El Bagre says, in El Bagre, we buy in Psycho Supermarket. Okay, very good. Institución Educativa del Mira Álvarez, they are having some problems. Okay, don't worry. Well, this part. Okay, Gaspar de Roa says, fruit and vegetables are very cheap. O Okay, interesting. This question, when do people go to the market? When do people go to the market? ¿Cuándo las personas van al mercado? For example, remember that I am from Florencia, Caquetá, very far from Medellín. In Florencia, people go to the market on Sundays. ¿Cierto? Por ejemplo, en Florencia son los domingos. There are other municipalities where people go to the market on Saturdays. En algunas partes son los sábados. Okay. For example, Elmir Álvarez says, on weekend, right? Weekend, Sunday. Very good. Lorenzo Yalí says, Sundays. Gaspar de Roda says, weekend. Okay, interesting. Y algo muy curioso, for example, in Florencia, es que allá hay dos mercados, ¿cierto? There are two markets. Uno son los domingos, that are people near from Florencia. Las personas, los campesinos que sacan sus productos, que viven ahí en la región, los sacan los domingos. But the groceries from Bogotá and from Pasto, porque llega mucho mercado de otra parte de Colombia, are Thursday, llega los jueves. So you see, in Florencia, for example, it's very different from here to Medellín or in Antioquia. Because in some of the towns, ¿cierto? En la mayoría de los municipios que están conectados ahora me dicen weekend, Sundays, específicamente los domingos. But there are other parts that you have to go to the market on Thursdays, also Sundays. Okay. For example, in El Bagre, people go to the market every day. Okay, you can go every day. But usually we buy on Sundays. Very good. For example, Gaspar de Roa says, Bogotá, Saturday and Sunday. Very good. Yes, that's interesting, right? So we are going to continue. Okay, I have another question. The last question. Do you go to the market too? Do you like to go to the market? Do you go with your parents to the market? Or do you go to the market to buy the food for your house? For example, Lorenzo Yalí says, yes, I go to the market. Edelmira Álvarez nos dice, Surtimax. Surtimax, maybe it's another store when you can buy the products. Okay, Gaspar de Roda says, yes, help to my parents. Okay, very interesting. So let's go to the presentation, let's move, because we have a listening activity, right? So we are going to listen a conversation, the idea, the goal of this listening activity is identificar ideas acerca de dónde comprar ingredientes. Ese es el objetivo, ¿cierto? Identificar ideas acerca de dónde comprar ingredientes. Las instrucciones son las siguientes. Read and listen to the following conversation between Juan Pablo and José. You will find information about a shopping list. Right? So, please, we are going to watch a video and to listen a record. So please pay attention and try to take notes. ¿Cierto? Vamos a prestar mucha atención, vamos a tratar de tomar apuntes. Remember that the first time you just have to listen. La primera vez simplemente vamos a escuchar. Second time, listen and read. Okay? So here we go.
Actividad introductoria. Shopping. Instruction. Read the following conversation between Juan Pablo and José. You will find information about a shopping list.
Hello, my friend. Are you ready for shopping?
Of course, my horse. I have the list of ingredients.
Perfect. You know, I have classes, but let me tell you where to buy these ingredients. Since I know all the stores in town.
All right. I will follow your instructions.
Thanks, brother. First, buy tilapia. To do that, you can go to the butcher's shop. Mr. Moses is a very nice person. He sells fresh tilapia. They cost 8,000 pesos per pound. Then, you shall go to the fruit and vegetable shop. It is located in front of Mr. Moses' shop. There, you shall buy some green plantains. 400 pesos each one. Lemons and garlics shouldn't cost you more than 2,000 pesos. Lemons cost 200 pesos each, and a bulb of garlic costs 1,000 pesos.
Can I buy the coconuts there?
No, you should go to the El Paisa fruit shop. They have good coconuts and a very good price. They cost 3,000 pesos each.
I know where it is. My mom often buys there. So, where can I buy the wheat flour and the rice?
Well, you shall find them at Luz Mini Market. It is just around the corner, next to the bank office. A pound of wheat flour costs only 1,000 pesos, and the rice costs 2,000 pesos a pound.
It is okay, my friend. Thanks for the directions. See you tomorrow. Have a nice class.
You're welcome. Bye bye.
Actividad introductoria.
Okay, so we have a very good listening activity. Tenemos mucha información, ¿cierto? En este audio. Vamos a ver. Por aquí me decían en algunas partes que les faltaba un poquitico más de volumen al audio. Traten de acomodar allá ustedes un poquito si pueden, porque aquí ya tenemos el video pues con el máximo de volumen. Okay. So, can you please share ideas with me? Ideas that you got from the video, from the listening. Vamos a ver si me pueden compartir ideas que nos quedaron de este audio. So, Institución Educativa Presbítero Jesús Antonio is typing. Okay. Recuerden que el objetivo era lugares donde puedo comprar ingredientes. So, let's try to pay attention to that. If you got something, please tell me. If not, don't worry. We watch the video again. Okay, yes, don't worry. Vamos a ver, por aquí me dicen que lo ponemos otra vez. Yes. So, do you want to listen? A ver, yo les pregunto, ¿lo escuchamos sin el script, sin las letras? ¿O lo escuchamos ya con la transcripción? Vamos a intentarlo una vez más. Eso, muy bien. Por aquí nos dicen, I have the list of ingredients. Vamos a intentarlo una vez más sin ver el script, ¿cierto? Sin ver la transcripción de lo que están hablando. Y luego si lo vemos con la transcripción. Ok, so pay attention. Here we go.
Actividad introductoria. Shopping. Instruction. Read the following conversation between Juan Pablo and Jose. You will find information about a shopping list.
Hello, my friend. Are you ready for shopping?
Of course, my horse. I have the list of ingredients.
Perfect. You know, I have classes, but let me tell you where to buy these ingredients. Since I know all the stores in town.
All right. I will follow your instructions.
Thanks, brother. First, buy tilapia. To do that, you can go to the butcher's shop. Mr. Moses is a very nice person. He sells fresh tilapia. They cost 8,000 pesos per pound. Then, you shall go to the fruit and vegetable shop. It is located in front of Mr. Moses' shop. There, you shall buy some green plantains. They cost 400 pesos each one. Lemons and garlics shouldn't cost you more than 2,000 pesos. Lemons cost 200 pesos each, and a bulb of garlic costs 1,000 pesos.
Can I buy the coconuts there?
No, you should go to the El Paisa fruit shop. They have good coconuts and a very good price. They cost 3,000 pesos each.
I know where it is. My mom often buys there. So, where can I buy the wheat flour and the rice?
Well, you shall find them at Luz Mini Market. It is just around the corner, next to the bank office. A pound of wheat flour costs only 1,000 pesos, and the rice costs 2,000 pesos a pound.
It is okay, my friend. Thanks for the directions. See you tomorrow. Have a nice class.
You're welcome. Bye bye.
Okay, very good. So Gaspar de Rodas is sharing ideas. For example, tilapia and garlic. Let's say and garlic. Tilapia and garlic in the paisa store. Okay, so we can buy the tilapia and garlic in the paisa store. What else? What other ingredients did you listen? Miren que en el audio teníamos ingredientes, lugar donde se compra y el precio también. Vamos a ver qué tanta información pudimos obtener con relación a esas tres categorías. Remember, the ingredient, the place, and the price. So we have tilapia and garlic in el paisa store. What else? No more. Oh my goodness. So don't worry about that. We are going to watch the video again. Vamos a escuchar otra vez el video. Esta vez lo vamos a escuchar con la transcripción. Y ustedes van a ir tomando apuntes. Lo que podemos hacer es que hacen las tres columnas: ingrediente, lugar y el precio. ¿Ok? Para que tomen apuntes en esas tres columnas y podamos compartir ahorita en el chat. So here we go again. So please pay attention.
Actividad introductoria. Shopping. Instruction. Read the following conversation between Juan Pablo and José. You will find information about a shopping list.
Hello, my friend. Are you ready for shopping?
Of course, my horse. I have the list of ingredients.
Perfect. You know, I have classes, but let me tell you where to buy these ingredients. Since I know all the stores in town.
All right. I will follow your instructions.
Thanks, brother. First, buy tilapia. To do that, you can go to the butcher's shop. Mr. Moses is a very nice person. He sells fresh tilapia. They cost 8,000 pesos per pound. Then you shall go to the fruit and vegetable shop. It is located in front of Mr. Moses' shop. There you shall buy some green plantains. They cost 400 pesos each one. Lemons and garlics shouldn't cost you more than 2,000 pesos. Lemons cost 200 pesos each, and a bulb of garlic costs 1,000 pesos.
Can I buy the coconuts there?
No, you should go to the El Paisa fruit shop. They have good coconuts and a very good price. They cost 3,000 pesos each.
I know where it is. My mom often buys there. So, where can I buy the wheat flour and the rice?
Well, you shall find them at Luz Mini Market. It is just around the corner, next to the bank office. A pound of wheat flour costs only 1,000 pesos, and the rice costs 2,000 pesos a pound.
It is okay, my friend. Thanks for the directions. See you tomorrow. Have a nice class.
You're welcome. Bye bye.
Okay, so let's go to the board. Vamos a ver si podemos. They have, completar esa tablita, por aquí nos dicen, they have good coconuts at a very good price. Yes, it's right. So what about the ingredient? Let's say coconuts. So in what place they can buy the coconut? Do you remember? No. Coconuts, where they can buy the coconuts? For example, tilapia. Where they can buy the tilapia? Very good, the lemons. Where they can buy the lemons? Okay, so we are going to do something. We are going to go back to the presentation and we are going to read. Okay? Vamos a leer aquí para seguir cogiendo más información. Ok, por aquí ya nos van compartiendo. De la Institución Educativa Presbítero Jesús Antonio. Tell me if it is Gómez, because I'm not sure. Tilapia in with place. So, Mr. Moses Store. So we can say that, for example. Moses Butchery. ¿Cierto? Lo llaman la carnicería. Very good. Green plantains. Okay. Por aquí me dicen salt. Right. So we are going to go back here. I want to ask you if some of you want to read. Si alguno desea leer, me dicen por el chat y desactivo micrófono. Por aquí nos dicen el Paisa Fruit Shop. So what can we buy in el Paisa Fruit Shop? Coconut, tilapia, lemons, green plantain, salt. ¿Qué podemos en el comprar en la Paisa Fruit Shop? Okay, the lemons. So, Paisa Fruit Shop. El Paisa Fruit Shop, right? El Paisa Fruit Shop. Shop. Lemons, 2,000 pesos. Okay, so let's say 2,000 pesos. Oil. Okay, they say tilapia 8,000 pesos per pound. So tilapia, we have, for example, 8,000 pesos per pound. Okay, the cost. We can say the cost of tilapia. The cost of el producto is. And we complete the sentence. Garlic, 1,000 pesos. 1,000 pesos. Okay, we have, for example, garlic. Right. 2,000 pesos. 1,000. Okay, so let's go back to the presentation. Hello, my friend. Are you ready for shopping? Of course, my horse. I have the list of ingredients. Perfect. You know I have classes, but let me tell you where to buy these ingredients, since I know all the stores in town. All right, I will follow your instructions. So, thanks, brother. Remember, if you want to read, please tell me. Por aquí nos dicen, the cost of coconut, 3 pesos. 3 pesos? I'm not sure. Okay. Thanks, brother. First, we buy tilapia. To do that, you can go to the butcher's shop. Mr. Moses is a very nice person. He sells fresh tilapia. They cost 8,000 pesos per pound. Very good information. Then you should go to the fruits and vegetables shop. Fruit and vegetable shop. It is located in front of Mr. Moses' shop. There you should buy some green plantains. So green plantains in the fruits and vegetable shop. They cost 400 pesos each one. So we can go here and we add 400 pesos each one. Okay. Lemons and garlic shouldn't cost you more than 2,000 pesos. Dice entonces que lemons and garlic no deberían costar más de 2,000 pesos. Lemons cost 200 pesos each. So lemons, we can say 200 pesos. Right, very good. And garlic cost 1,000 pesos, right? So the garlic, let's say 1,000 pesos. Yes, very good, Lorenzo Yali. The cost of each green plantain is 400 pesos. Very good. Miren que podemos utilizar esta estructura para hacer las oraciones. So the garlic, yes, 1,000 pesos. So we continue here, sorry. Yes, 1,000 pesos. Can I buy the coconuts there? ¿Puedo comprar los coconuts there? No. You should go to El Paisa Fruit Shop. They have good coconuts at a very good price. They cost 3,000 pesos each. So we go back and the coconut, let's say, right? And the lemons is not El Paisa Fruit Shop. Cierto, los limones no son en la tienda del Paisa, but the coconut, yes. El Paisa Fruit Shop. Okay. I know, where is it? My mom often goes, often buys there. So, where can I buy the wheat flour and the rice? ¿Dónde compramos el arroz? Dice, well, you should find them at Lou's Mini Market. So, at Lou's Mini Market. It is just around the corner next to the bank office. A pound of wheat flour costs only 1,000 pesos. And the rice costs 2,000 pesos a pound. It is okay, my friend. Thank you. Thanks for the directions. See you tomorrow. Have a nice class. You are welcome. Bye bye. So, I think that now we have more information to do the next activity. Right? So, first of all, what ingredients do they need? Where can they buy the ingredients? How much is one of the ingredients? How much are all the ingredients? Entonces, miren que era lo que estábamos haciendo aquí, ¿cierto? Pero yo creo que aquí colocamos más ingredientes de los que ellos estaban hablando. Right, for example, oil, no, they didn't talk about oil, right? Salt, no, they didn't talk about salt. But garlic, yes. Cierto, de garlic sí hablamos. So we are going to organize the information. Vamos a ver, ¿qué otra información nos falta acá? That you remember, ¿qué otros ingredientes nos faltan aquí? What other things we have to write? ¿Qué otros ingredientes de los que ellos estuvieron hablando nos hacen falta en esta lista que estamos haciendo? Very good, Lorenzo Yalí. Very good, Institución Educativa del Mira Álvarez. Let's say, with flour, that is harina de trigo, and rice, okay? And what place? ¿En qué lugar los podemos comprar esos productos? Do you remember? Please let me know. Let's try to participate. Hey, what happened with the other institutions? What happened, for example, with Liz Andrade? Right, Liceo El Bagre, Gaspar de Rodas, San José de Betulia. Okay, very good. Luz Mini Market. So we can say that we can buy that at Luz Mini Market. Mini Market, right? Okay. And these other are about fruit and vegetable shop. Okay. So here we have like the information, right? Okay, so let's continue with the other part. Actividad de comprensión. Entonces, para esta actividad de comprensión, lo que vamos a hacer es que vamos a revisar el material que tenemos en el espacio de la mochila. Right? Que es este material que tenemos acá. Yes. Que es para hablar de los precios que utilizamos para... en inglés y en español. Aquí está la parte de inglés solamente y nosotros vamos a hablar un poquito del español. So, let's talk about prices. Okay? So, in English, we divide prices at the decimal. Entonces, en inglés, como hablamos en dólares, ¿cierto? En dólares, dividimos los números por los decimales. Entonces, aquí tenemos, por decir algo, este número, este precio. Y lo vamos a decir $4, podemos incluir el and 59 cents, $4.59, o la forma rápida de decirlo sería 4.59, o sea 4.59, ¿cierto? Miren entonces que hay dos formas de decirla, la forma larga y la forma corta. $4.59, o lo podemos decir 4.59. Mucho cuidado que aquí estamos hablando de precios, ¿cierto? De precios. Usualmente cuando son números grandes, ellos lo dicen en parejitas. Por ejemplo, 267. 267, muchas veces lo pueden decir 267. 2.67. Recuerden que estamos hablando de precios, ¿ok? Aquí, por ejemplo, cuando es $4,381, $4,381. Ellos lo pueden decir también la forma corta, 4381, 4381. Hacen la separación en parejitas. Listo, entonces, ahora vamos a hablar un poquito del español. ¿Cómo decimos los precios en español? Así como los vimos en el video, entonces, por ejemplo, si son... You can say 5,000. $5,000. Right? For example, this one. So we can say 2,500 pesos. Okay? So to do this activity, we need to pay attention to that. So what we have to do is that we are going to compare precios. To compare prices, sorry. Vamos a comparar precios y aquí vamos a suponer un poquito, sobre todo en los precios de nosotros. Dicen, vamos a coger los ingredientes de la receta que ellos van a preparar, ¿cierto? De lo que ellos están hablando, esos ingredientes. Aquí tenemos los precios que ellos nos reportaron, ¿cierto? Tilapias, they cost 8,000 pesos per pound. Lugar donde se compra, Mr. Moses Shop. Y después, en esta otra parte, vamos entonces a hablar de esos ingredientes, pero en nuestro municipio. Por ejemplo, las tilapias para los personajes que estábamos viendo cuestan 8,000 pesos por libra y se compran en Mr. Moses Shop. Pero en nuestro municipio, they cost 9,000 pesos per pound, cuestan 1,000 pesos más, o sea 9,000 pesos por libra. ¿Y dónde se compra? Se compran en la Amistad Butcher's Shop, ¿cierto? Se compran en la carnicería La Amistad. Y aquí escribimos una comparación. In my town, tilapias are more expensive than in Juan Pablo's town. Listo, entonces vamos a completar esta tablita. Ustedes me van escribiendo en el chat rápidamente la información y yo voy escribiéndola en la tabla para que hagamos esta actividad. Right? Is it clear or maybe you can have questions? For example, what about the prices of plantains in El Carmen? Or what about the prices of plantains in Betulia? Or for example, in Carolina del Príncipe? Please share information in the chat. What about the prices in, for example, in Jali? What about that prices? Okay, in the Marx's store. But could you please write the complete sentence? Vamos a intentar escribir oraciones completas siguiendo el modelo que tenemos aquí en el primer ejemplo. So please, tratemos de seguir el ejemplo que tenemos ahí en la primera columna para tratar de hacer nuestras oraciones. Right? Por ejemplo, plantains. They cost, okay, very good, 1,000 per pound. Por aquí en el bagre nos dicen, el bagre is very expensive. Vamos a ver qué tan costoso es. Gaspar de Rodas, Infredonia nos dicen, the plantains, so we can say, they cost 1,000 per pound, right? So we can say Alejo's store. Okay. Por ejemplo, aquí voy a escribir mientras tanto lo que nos comparten from el bagre. They cost 12 lemons, 2,000. So let's say like 200 pesos each, more or less. They cost 200 pesos each. Okay. Gaspar de Rodas says, for example, in my town, let's say plantain, so they are more expensive than in Monteria, right? Okay, yes, more expensive than in Monteria. What about, I don't know, the garlics? They cost 2,000 pesos each. So what about in your town? How much does it cost? How much? Okay, Gaspar de Rodas is typing. Or the coconuts, or the wheat flour, or the rice. So, the one that you prefer, don't worry about that. Okay, the lemons cost 50 pesos each. Okay, lemons. Por ejemplo, nos comparten desde Infredonia. They are very cheap. We can say, for example, 50 pesos each. Presbítero Jesús Antonio says, the rice cost 1,000, the rice. It cost 1,000 per pound. Where Mercosto, right? Okay, very good. Thank you very much, Presbítero Jesús Antonio, for sharing that information. So the idea is that you complete the chart. La idea es que completemos this chart with the information. Remember that you have also this activity in the platform. So, in the Gaspar de Roa says, in the street there are many lemons. Okay, so in that town, for example, in Fredonia, lemons are in every part. Okay, so we are going to continue. Very good for your participation. Thank you very much for sharing your information. I'm going to move to the actividad guiada, right? ¿Cuál es el objetivo de esta actividad guiada? Dar información acerca de cómo preparar un plato de comida, right? Entonces van a pensar en un plato que a ustedes les guste para que den las instrucciones de cómo prepararlo. This is the instruction. Record a short video showing your peers how to prepare one of your favorite dishes. Remember to mention all the ingredients and cooking times. Bueno, entonces, ¿cuál es la idea? La idea es hacer un video mostrando cómo preparar un plato, ¿cierto? Un plato que nos guste. Recuerden que no tiene que ser obligatoriamente un video, ya los profes les indican en qué formato lo van a presentar. But the purpose is to practice speaking. La idea es que practiquemos speaking y que podamos contar cómo preparar el plato de comida que más nos gusta. ¿Qué van a tener en cuenta para la presentación, para lo que van a contar sobre ese plato de comida? The name of the dish. Name of the dish. Ingredients. Right? Ingredients. Quantities. Cantidades. And procedures and times. Recuerden que en la sesión anterior vimos un video de cómo preparaban una tilapia. Miren que ahí explicaban los procesos. Primero, corte tal cosa. Segundo, úntelo con limón. Tercero, agréguele ajo. Cuarto, haga esto. So, you can have that instructions. Y también tenemos unas recomendaciones de palabritas que se llaman conectores que ustedes pueden utilizar cuando vayan a dar esas instrucciones, ese paso a paso. Tenemos aquí first, primero, then, luego, later, más tarde, next, después o siguiente, after that, después de eso, y tenemos finally. Entonces miren que ustedes pueden ir utilizando esas palabritas para dar las instrucciones para preparar ese plato de comida. So, remember, think about your favorite dish. Piensen en el plato favorito. Think about the ingredients. Piensen sobre los ingredientes que van a necesitar. Think about the process. Piensen acerca del proceso. And then write the instructions, ¿cierto? Preparan pues como la hacen el borrador de la presentación. And finally, you do the presentation. Remember that this activity is guided by the Aula teacher. So, if you have questions, please let me know. Remember that I'm going to be in the chat some minutes after this session in order to answer your questions. I want to say thank you. I want to say thank you to the institutions. For example, Institución Educativa Gaspar de Rodas, Institución Educativa Luis Andrade, Institución Educativa Nuevo Horizonte, Institución Educativa San José de Betulia. We have Presbítero Jesús Antonio. We have Institución Educativa del Mira Álvarez. And we have Liceo El Bagre. Right? So thank you very much. And also I want to say thank you to the institutions that observe these classes from YouTube. For example, Institución Educativa Tanasio Girardot. We have Institución Educativa Guillermo Aguilar. We have Institución Educativa Santa Rosa de Lima en Giraldo. Institución Educativa La Esmeralda en El Bagre. Institución Educativa Colombia en Carepa. Institución Educativa Cecilia Duque de Duque en Abejorral. Institución Educativa Gabriela Mistral en Copacabana. We have also Institución Educativa Mariano de Jesús EUCC Rural Chocholoma en Angostura. And finally, Institución Educativa La Trinidad in Arboletes. Remember that the way to learn English is practicing. So, thank you for your time and see you in the next session. Bye-bye.